Hi, I'm Lisa Rose. I'm a spiritual coach and intuition expert. And today I'm in here to share with you this one technique that I teach my clients in my coaching program on how to instantly make better choices and decisions for themselves. In the program, we are working with creative women on a quest for change in midlife. And that means a whole lot of new options and changes are being looked at, and sometimes we're not quite sure if we should go this way or go that way, or take this opportunity or that opportunity. And here's a technique that you can use to gather some information very quickly and clearly understand the best way for you. Okay, so first, choices are when everything is pretty much equally beneficial to you. You're just going to have to pick one, right? They're all going to have a good result. Decisions are when you're taking a look at all of your options, and then you're deciding which one is going to be best for you. Okay? So whether you're working with choices or decisions, this technique works. And this is where you have your choice or your decision in front of you, and the first thing you do is you are checking with your head. So we're going to check with our head, our heart, and then our spirit. Right? So we're going to get three different kinds of information this way. So always check with your head first. This is the me, right? So me, myself, and I. So we're going to check with me. We're going to check with the head first. Is this a good choice for me? Which of these choices seems to be the best one for me? Is this decision going to get me where I want to go? How do we feel about this particular decision? Then you check with your heart. Which of these choices is best for me? And the heart will make a choice. Then you can say, is this decision the best thing for me in my highest and best good now? What does my heart say about this? I know what my head's saying. Is my heart saying the same thing, or is my heart saying something different? And this is where people sort of get tripped up because their head will say something and their heart will say something else, and now they don't know which way to go. Because this is making rational sense, maybe this is not making rational sense. We start to self-doubt, right? So this is why asking the spirit, ask the head, ask the heart, and then you ask the spirit the same question. What does my spirit say about this choice or this decision that I've made? And that response is the one that you can always count on. Because the spirit is responding to your inquiry, to your question, to your wondering from a different place. It's responding from the place of the soul's entire journey, its purpose, its divine gift that's meant to be shared, the lessons that it's already learned, and it's a much broader response that is beneficial and in alignment and congruent with the soul, right? The heart is pretty emotional, right? The heart is going to respond to how it feels, right? The spirit is, how is this aligned to my best purpose or my best good, why I'm here? How does it fit into that alignment? The head's job is to say, wait a minute. We don't really like change. Is this change going to be good? Are we afraid? Why are we afraid? We would rather be afraid. We know how to do that. It's too much. It's too soon. We want a guarantee, right? It's creating all the flags, that go up to keep us out of danger, right? It's doing its job. So you have to understand that you give the head a chance to say what it needs to say, and you gather that as information rather than as direction. Then you listen to the heart. You give the heart a chance to speak and to say, so that now you have another perspective for how you want to feel. And then you allow the spirit, right, to communicate to you about how this is aligned with you or how this is not aligned with you. Spirit is not going to tell you what to do. It's going to describe how this fits in alignment or how this doesn't fit into alignment. And then you get to choose if you're going to go in alignment or if you're going to go out of alignment. Sometimes people go out of alignment just for the experience, and then they end up in jail. Just kidding. It usually doesn't end well, but sometimes it happens, right? So don't beat yourself up about it. You just go back again and you say, okay, that wasn't for my best good. Somewhere I got tripped up. Let me check with my head. Let me check with my heart. Let me check with my spirit. And where am I on the soul's journey? So I hope that that's helpful for you. And use that the next time you have a choice or a decision, big or small. Start small till you get used to how it works. And then you'll be able to use it. And instantly, you have all the information that you need in order to be able to make the right choice for you at this time and also to make the right decision. Okay. So this is one of the exercises that is going to be in my Truly Living You group coaching program. I'm going to be talking about Truly Living You group coaching, creating a life you love, giving up your discontentment, getting more happiness, taking baby steps, all of that this week. I have a program that I'm launching next week, and I've got only 20 seats. And I know that for those of you that are on a quest for change, this program will be great for you. So check in with me again. I've got something great for you again tomorrow, and I hope I will see you there. If you're interested in the program, you can click on Learn More when I boost this, or you can go up to the top of the page on Learn More and check it out. Okay. Love from here. Bye for now.